stars. Aren't they volatile? They love wars and they love shooting. But entropy and the second law of thermodynamics keep them in check. But first, a question.
Which is more volatile, a glass of water or a glass of ice? Well, it's not the glass of ice. We know that ice is solid and cold, therefore has lower temperature and less energy. And when you're low on energy, you prefer to lie down and be still. Like us, particles with less energy have less movement. They vibrate about their fixed positions, neatly arranged. The glass of water is in a liquid state and is hotter than ice, so there's more energy in it. And when you're energetic, it's incredibly hard to stay put. Particles feel the same way too, so they collide with each other and the wall of the glass, and everything is in a vigorous chaos.
So we understand now that the water is more volatile, but what am I supposed to do with this information? Well, now we can talk about entropy. Entropy is the measure of molecular disorder in a system. Yep, we're quantifying chaos.
To tackle this paradoxical principle, we'll take an equally complex example from daily life. The paradigm of human invention, the donut. Let's have two, a frosted and a glazed. The frosted has three ends, A, B, C, while the glazed has D all alone. Now if we push them together, they'll be in contact and the ends can move between the donuts. This is known as a microstate. End A on the frosted is one microstate, while end A on the glazed is another. With microstates, we're talking about the circumstances of a single element. A macrostate talks about the ratio of ends on frosted to ends on glazed. There are four ends, so only these ratios are possible. Macrostates are a set of microstates. Not all macrostates have the same likelihood of occurring, and the likelihood is determined by the number of microstates that produce that macrostate. Take 4 to 0. Four microstates produce it. That is, ends A, B, C, and D are all on the frosted donut. Macrostate 2 to 2 has 24 microstates, as so. This means the ends would rather be equally distributed than concentrated on a single donut.
The second law of thermodynamics states that in exchanges of energy in an isolated system, entropy increases or stays constant.
Entropy decreases when clouds of gas condense to form stars, but increases much more when these stars release heat and light.
Entropy isn't as chaotic as it seems. It's ridiculously common in our lives. It's why ice melts, why tires deflate. It's why my hair gets progressively messier as the video goes by. So the next time you or your room look more paleolithic than pristine, blame entropy. It's 'cause you're a star.